We have just received this news, and I was going to thank everybody anyway. They seem to enjoy my review of WrestleMania that we did last week. Almost everybody did. We'll talk about a couple of fucking, there's an SOB in every crowd. We'll talk about a couple of them in a second, but everybody enjoyed the WrestleMania review. It was our top downloaded or viewed YouTube channel clip. Of course, Corny YouTube is available 24 hours a day for the lonely and lost in the middle of the night. If you need a place to turn a soothing voice of anger and hatred and frustration, come on over to Corny YouTube. But anyway, so we're going to do some more current stuff, I guess. You're talking me into watching some more current stuff in the future because people seem to like it. But there was a few that didn't. And you know why, Brian? You know what did I say about Charlotte's match?
I think you said that you thought it was the second best match in the show after the Rousey match.
Yeah. And that Charlotte is a tremendous athlete and that did some incredible stuff. And a lot of their work looked better than some of the guys on the show and for reasons I gave and et cetera. And I criticized one thing. I said it, and I even admitted I would be sexist about this in a joking fashion, because obviously if you've ever studied biology or anatomy, I didn't go off kilter into opinion here. I said, the vertical suplex off the apron onto the floor was too much for me for a 130-pound girl that doesn't have any padding and et cetera, et cetera. And I didn't make up biology and anatomy, folks. Women's bodies are not built to handle shit like that, as men's are not either. So it was an exceptional risk for the women. And I said, I didn't like that because I don't want her to get hurt. But otherwise than that, you know. And how many spinal injuries are we seeing in wrestling these days? Anyway, otherwise than that, everything was copacetic and hunky-dory to box fluffy ducks. And then one of these fucking websites. And I think, I don't know whether to fault the website because it's just the fact that their readers, if they're reading that website, they're not that bright to begin with, or whether the readers aren't that bright because they read these stupid websites. But it was some... It wasn't PW Insider, because if Mike Johnson says something, then it's factual. It wasn't Wrestling Observer or Figure Four, because if Dave Meltzer and Brian Alvarez say something, it's factual. Well, except for some of their opinions on current day wrestlers in the industry, but that's clearly labeled an opinion. But then there's the Wrestle Zones and Wrestle Source and Wrestle Crap and Wrestle Fucking Wrestle My Ass. And they apparently took out a screenshot or whatever. They not only didn't say I critiqued the match, they said I criticized the match because they didn't know the difference. But then they put the only thing I say, and yeah, they shouldn't have taken that bump. That's not for the girls. And I get like 7 to 9 just persistent fucking feminists, most of them male, just on my ass. How dare you? Oh, my God. Charlotte is an incredible sensation, and she should be allowed to do anything the men could do. And why? You sexist old pig. Why did? Holy fuck. I mean, the most acid chappedness that I'd ever say. It was like that I'd said they should all both be, you know, in the kitchen barefoot and pregnant or whatever. And it wasn't even the context of what I said anyway. So just please, if I know that nobody listened to this program needs to be have this explained, but if you have one of these people in your social circle, whether they're a Trump supporter or a Wrestle fucking Source supporter or whatever, try to smarten them up. Do a public service so the rest of us don't have to. Oh, goddamn, it's not even worth trying. Some people just can't be smartened up.